Hi guys, so today I'm going to be doing a video of how I stay organized and how I do notes and study for college. So first, I like taking notes on my computer when I'm at my dorm, when I'm taking textbook notes, but when I'm in class, sometimes I don't like to bring my laptop to class. Even though I have the MacBook Air and it's really, really light, I just find like sometimes it's just unnecessary weight when I have to bring a notebook for some classes. So first we'll start off how I take notes in class. So in class, I use a multi-subject notebook, and if it isn't a multi-subject notebook, just do little dividers with sticky notes. And so this is for my biology and my music class. And this notebook I actually showed in a hall, and it's the Focus Notes by Topps brand notebook, and it's just the column style notes where they have the header right here, and then you write your information right next to it. So, as you can see, I have headers on the side. It says Q column, and I just write the topic. So this one is just subatomic particles of atoms, and under that I just do different subsections, and then under that I either do a dot or a dash or a line or something to signify that it goes with the subsection, and all the subsections go with the main header. So that's basically the style of notes that I take for all. And I just like to highlight the important ideas or key ideas so that I can easily flip through my notes and say, oh, we're talking about polar bonds, like, oh, here's polar, and then just look at that stuff. So that's what I do. I also occasionally do diagrams and stuff like that. I basically take like every single note down that the teacher writes. A rule of thumb is that if the teacher writes something on the board, you should write it down in your notes. Also, what I do in class, even though some of my classes like biology where it's a lecture, the PowerPoints that are used in class are submitted to an online service like Blackboard. Even though the notes are on there and it's very tempting to not go to class because the notes are already online or that not take notes during class, I find that the notes on Blackboard I can look back to and refer to if I have any questions or I feel like I didn't copy down something right. But I find that it's really important to take your own notes and explain things in your own words and you would personally understand. I take notes in all my classes and basically in that format. Notes outside of class is a little different. I open my Microsoft Word on my Mac. I have different templates and layouts, and I select the Word notebook layout. And basically, I can't really show you how it looks on my computer since I'm using my computer. Basically, this is what it looks like when you print it. And this is for my communication class last semester, so this is how the notes would look when I printed it. So basically it's like the same setup that I showed in my notebook, but it's a little different and it does all the bullets and everything for you in this layout. So I start with no indentation and I start with the header of the section. So that can be just like the main title, like introduction. So as you can see, under introduction, it says miscommunication. So I indent it once. Subsection of the main section of introduction, if that makes any sense. Do another indentation, and that's all the stuff that goes under the miscommunication. Under miscommunication, there's another subsection called tone. And under tone, there's more information that goes in depth about tone. So I do another indentation, and it has another bullet point that looks different than the original, and then I just explain tone a little more. So it's just, I keep indenting more and more and more if it applies, if something goes more in depth. I like to bold the section titles, I like to underline the subsections, and if there's a keyword which is normally bolded in textbooks, I like to highlight it. It's in black and white, I never print in color, so it just shows a little gray box for highlighted stuff, but obviously I know it's important, and if you really want to see something highlighted or in a different color, but yet you want to print black and white, you can just easily take a highlighter and highlight it, which you could do after you printed things too. So I really recommend that program. It really is nice to stick to the same routine that I use for notebook notes, also on computer notes, and it's really organized and just makes it really, really easy to go back and look at your notes and study from them. I definitely recommend the Microsoft Notebook layout, but if you don't have that program, you can just easily do the same thing with indentations and bullet points and all that stuff. So how I pick out the information that I want to select to take notes on with my textbook is really anything that I personally find important or that's bolded in the textbook. So in my mass media class. I'll look for an exam. I actually got this book used, so there was some highlighted sections already in the book. You can highlight in the books, but I find that when you highlight this much, it's kind of just like you're highlighting to color and not really the important information. What I do is, this section's highlighted again, but what I do is I just read every section like, so here's the main title of the section, and this is where I would indent onto different subsections. And as you can see, there's bolded words right there. So basically anything that I find important, the information, and a lot of times the bolded words I find really important, or if something is around the bolded word lines, that's really important. But I do read everything because I do find that there's a lot of stuff that's not bolded or not italicized or anything that I find that's really important. A lot of times stuff on quizzes, yes, they can be the bolded stuff, but a lot of times they want to make sure that you're doing all the reading, so they'll ask questions that necessarily aren't bolded in the textbooks. I also like to take notes on things that might be silly in the textbooks, but they can also make me understand it more. So I definitely do like examples or things that it makes me think of, and I write that under with a little asterisk or something to help me remember. I am someone that keeps all my paperwork until the semester ends or even to the year. I have saved all my paperwork from last semester because I don't really know if I'll need that stuff later on, especially in classes like math and English. I have this huge, I believe it's a 2-inch binder where it just has class papers in it, and if you look inside, it is packed. This is my last semester binder, and I just have all these paperworks and stuff that I got handed back, assignments, papers I've written, math packets, and it is all organized with dividers with labels on them so I can easily flip through and find the class that I'm looking for. So I definitely recommend either filing your papers away or getting a binder just to easily store the things that you receive back from your teachers. You never know if your teacher doesn't put in a grade correctly and then you have the assignment to back up and say, no, I actually got this grade. So I just keep everything, plus it's good for looking back purposes. Other than a notebook for in-class paperwork, I recently just got this 5-star like folder, binder folder. Really what it is that it's a binder that you can fold, and it looks like a folder. It's flat, it's easy to transport, it doesn't take up a lot of room, and that's exactly what I was looking for. So I just have, it came with all these tabs, and I just have all my classes in these tabs. And then in the back of it, it just has lined paper, and I just keep my assignments that I'm currently working on or papers that I need to keep with me on hand. When I finish like a writing assignment in a paper, I can then file that stuff away in a different binder because I don't need it on hand with me in English class. So I just carry this around for all my stuff, and it just keeps things organized, and it's very light and easy to access. And I definitely recommend one of these. They're kind of pricey and they're more expensive than binders. Like it's something that will last a long time, and it's the only like binder I really needed this semester to carry around all my stuff. So I really recommend one of these if you're not a huge binder person. Another good way to stay organized, and how I stay organized, is with a planner. So if you watched my What's in My Backpack video for first semester, I'll leave the link down below if you haven't. I showed that I had my planner with me, and I don't honestly carry my planner with me all the time. This planner I just got at Walmart. It was really inexpensive. A lot of schools give planners away, and I actually have my school's planner right behind me actually. And that's basically where I just write things that I need to do that day. It could be anything from do laundry to work out to write English paper. So that's just always on my desk, and I always see what I need to do. This one is a little different. It's more of a calendar layout. I do have the day by day, but I personally do not write my homework down every single day, especially in class, because every class has a syllabus and it tells you exactly when things are due. So if we go back to my 5-star note folder binder thing, I have in this clear dividers, I have the syllabus for every class. And so then it's the first thing that I open when I get to the section, so I can see what the homework is due for this week or next class, and then I just highlight when I do something. So that's kind of like my planner for assignments. However, if you don't think that method would work well for you or that you find that you would forget a lot of things, I definitely recommend getting a planner. And I still have a planner just for like monthly things and just reminders of tests and stuff. So like I said, I don't really carry this around me all the time, but I think it's really important to refresh your memory and see everything that you need to do for a certain day in like chronological order, or just that it's just written in one space instead of just flipping through your binder and seeing what's due on the syllabus. Planners are definitely an easy accessory for staying organized. Lastly, I have three different tools that I use to study and take notes and organize my life and schoolwork: flashcards, post-its, and highlighters or markers. So first I'll start off with highlighters or markers. I use highlighters, obviously. I showed you in my notes how I use highlighters. I don't highlight everything, even though it can be fun, but I do color code everything. Color coding is not only fun for me, but you really stay organized and you can really see what goes with what. So I really recommend color coding, and it's a fun way just to make things colorful and happy and not so dull. And if everything's black and blue ink, you're not gonna be able to get your eyes drawn to a certain thing and you're just gonna zone over all your notes. So I really recommend mixing it up with some colors, and studies show that if you do mix it up with some colors that you learn information better and stay more attentive during the time that you're writing notes and studying. Next, post-its. I probably use post-its the most out of anything, and that's not just school purposes. I use post-its nonstop. I have a couple different colors, and you can get post-its anywhere. I find that like Walmart's like the cheapest, obviously, for a lot of things. I use post-its as daily reminders, post-its for separating papers, post-its for things I need to do for the day. Like, I use post-its everywhere, and I definitely think it's a good way to stay organized, and just to-do lists and everything. You can just use post-its for everything. And like I said, they're colorful and fun and a nice way to draw your attention to something. There's also these mini like page marker post-its, which are really good for textbooks if you find important information, especially if you aren't gonna write in the books. Then you can just flag it and write like a little message if you don't want to use a whole post-it. So these things are really handy too. For studying, note cards are my number one study habit that just works for me. So I definitely recommend getting flashcards if you're that kind of person. I like to learn things in many different ways, and repetition really helps me. What I do the flashcards is I basically do all the key terms or key information that maybe my professor has given me, or stuff that I just personally thought was important to learn, and I write them all out a couple days before I plan on studying or a couple days before my test. And then slowly I will do half the section and I'll do three at a time. So basically what I do, and this really works for me and it's worked for a few of my friends, is I pick three flashcards and I learn those three terms or whatever. I like pacing around. It helps me if that's like, if you can't just sit still and do it. Pacing really, really helps me. So I pace around my dorm, especially in my room, and I say it out loud. And then when I have those three nailed down, I will put them aside and get three more flashcards. Once I get those three down, then I mix together so I have six flashcards, and I'll see if I can remember those. And I won't go on to the next three until I remember those six. And so on and so on. I'll just add to the pile, and soon enough I'll have all my stuff done in one huge pile, and by the time you have so much repetition that you have to know your terms. So that's something that really, really helps me, and if I have like terms that I need to know by heart, that's what I do, and I totally recommend it if you're someone that needs repetition for learning. So those are the three tools that I use for studying and staying organized. And lastly, I just want to recommend getting a hole puncher. I find that a lot of professors obviously don't hole punch things that were not in high school anymore. So this one's just like one of those ones that can stay in the binder. It's not the best for, I mean, like large stacks of papers, but it's really helpful and it keeps everything organized so you can put it in your binder and just tuck it away. So I totally recommend getting one of these if you don't already. So those are my tips of how I stay organized and how I study, kind of. If you guys want to see any more videos from me, let me know. If you have any suggestions, and if you want to see more college videos from me, don't forget to subscribe. Thank you guys so much for watching, and have an awesome day. Bye.